I am Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. You're here with Byron Beck from ByronBeck.com. And speaking of, this is the most ham-handed segue. I was just going to, speaking of changes and evolutions, because I'd written that and it seemed like a really great way to segue it. But I don't even know, and I say this with alarming frequency, the status of a lot of gay rights in Portland and Oregon, because I think also they're two different sets of laws, the county, Multnomah County and Oregon, and also because they just seem to be in sort of a constant state of flux. It seems like on the one hand, Portland is as progressive as people would think, but on the other hand, we're sort of lagging behind what we as Portlanders feel the law probably is or should be. So where is...
It's so funny because you sound like every straight person I know. So, I mean...
Rick Emerson is every straight man.
We live in a very small city. And I would say in some ways we're very provincial. And that in public we espouse progressive thought, but in private we're pretty conservative people. And that's played out over the years, especially in the issue of equality and civil rights and gay rights. As a gay rights activist, when I'm not a journalist, it's been an interesting time.
What do you mean I sound like every straight person you know?
Well, you sound confused, and you sound like you really don't stay informed about what is probably one of the most important civil rights issues of our time.
I think the issue for a lot of people is that it does seem to be a constantly shifting thing. A good example of that is, if I'm not mistaken, you and your partner Juan had been married.
We were domestically partnered.
Domestically partnered. So, for folks that had gotten married and then those marriages, and it sounds insane to even use this phrase, but their marriages were voided,
right.
which is just a surreal thing. It's almost like the hand of the Almighty came down and,
it's such
a bizarre concept. I actually was having a discussion with somebody about this, and we were wondering how that even worked. Did something arrive in the mail from the state that actually just said, "Dear married person, you are no longer married."
Yeah, signed, and you got your check back.
It seems that the tone and temperature of Portland, and the mentality of Portland, and then the actuality of things are often at odds. What is your sense for where this will be in 3 or 4 or 5 or 10 years?
I really believe that eventually, the more we speak to people, the more we get out there and talk to people individually, over a long period of time, they'll realize, people that voted to say that marriage is only between a man and a woman, will realize that people who love each other should have the right to be with each other, and should have the right to spend their lives with these people, and to be able to protect each other. I think it's just a really simple message that we continue to show people that people who love each other deserve the right to be with each other.
Let's talk a bit about Basic Rights Oregon. How did you come to be involved with that group?
Well, they tried really hard to get me fired because of something I'd written in the paper. And through that, I became a little bit more familiar with their organization as they were trying to, you know, run me out of town. Over the years, I became more involved in what they were involved in, and eventually me and my partner, we spent 4 years trying to overturn Measure 36, which is that marriage is between a man and a woman, and we ended up failing. That was not so much fun. The positive side out of all this is that eventually my partner was hired to be their development director, and I've become a very motivated supporter of Basic Rights Oregon.
You've got a fundraiser that's coming up tomorrow night, including folks such as yourself and also Poison Waters, who's known to many Portlanders. What's going to be
Poison Waters is a wonderful female impersonator, and she is also quite the entertainer, and we're going to do an event at the Original. It starts at 8 p.m. It's only $10. We'll do cocktail samplings. We'll do hors d'oeuvre samplings. We're going to make cookies. It's going to be all sorts of fun. Words I can't say on TV. It's going to be all sorts of words I can't say on TV.
Despite the fact that I am apparently every straight person you know, which means that I need to be buying Haeger slacks, I guess, I think somewhere.
Yeah, with an elastic waistband.
With an elastic waistband. Saying things like, this band is really boss. They put down some tasty licks. I will say that Poison Waters, I mean, gay, straight, male, female, that's a scorchingly hot aesthetic that Poison Waters has going on.
Yeah, it'll be fun. It'll be at the original, which is on 6th and Salmon. And, no, 6th and Oak. And it'll be a great event.
On that not at all awkward note, we're going to take a break. We'll come back after this with more of Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay there.
Did you just touch me?
I think so. It was an accident.